Hey folks, it's Bishopheals from the ECF forums. How you guys doing today, baby? Let me tell you, I'm here because I'm gonna do an experiment. Oh yeah, man, it's happy Monday. Let me tell you, beautiful day today. And you know what? It's time to do an experiment, okay? Now, this is something that Imeo has mentioned on the GG forums, and I was curious to give it a go. I asked him for his blessing, and gave me his blessing to give it a go. So, you know what the experiment is? Here we go. We're not gonna oxidize mesh. We're gonna use mesh. I just rolled up a mesh right now, as you can see. It's not oxidized, okay? No oxidation. Now, the experiment is, how would it work as a resistance conductive wire by itself, okay? What'd I say? Okay, in plain English, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna tie a non-resistance wire on both ends of this mesh, make the mesh conductive, and use it as the actual resistance wire with no silica wick, just mesh, okay? And you could drip right on it, and hopefully it gives me a great vape. That's what we're gonna do today. So I'm gonna do this on the OD drip mode, okay? So let's get started. Okay, so as I said, we're going to be using a non-resistance wire. I'm going to use 32 gauge non-resistance wire, nickel, without oxidizing the mesh, okay? I'm going to use the OD drip mode, okay? Okay, so now I have the piece of non-resistance wire. Here's the mesh and my OD drip mode, okay? So the way I'm gonna mount this non-resistance wire, I'm gonna twist I am going to do a twist on the mesh. So I'm gonna position the non-resistance wire about here, about that distance, okay? And I'm gonna do a twist. Keep twisting and twisting. And you can do this with your hands or a pair of pliers. Okay, so okay, so now, before you do the final tightening, now you can move the non-resistance wire a little bit to the edge, okay? And then from there, what you can do is, you can take a pair of pliers, now apply more pressure, gently. You don't want the wire to break. And see if it moves. If it moves, you want to apply a little bit more pressure, more twists. There we go. So it will look like this. See? Just like that. Now, make sure it's a little snug. It is, because we're going to be yanking on it, you know, like so. So you don't want this wire to come off. Doing wraps somehow, when you're going to yanked down, it's gonna come out. And instead of me doing a twist with the mesh to ruin the stainless steel, I kind of thought, let me give this kind of build a try and see if this would actually work. So far, it's pretty snug. I can yank. Doesn't come out of the mesh. So that works. Now what I'll do is I'll measure it. There we go. So that looks good. Okay. Now what I'll do is, now I have to cut the other end. Measure the other end. And the way I'm going to do it is push it, push this end so it can't go no more because of the wire, and then hold it, take a nail clipper, and then cut it. Like so. Now it's flush. Now what I do is, now I put the non-resistance wire on this side. Hold it with your nail and start twisting. And as you twist, you pull with a little bit of resistance to keep the twist straight. There we go. Check it. Okay, I could use a little bit more. There we go. So here it looks. Okay. Now, being that this is an experiment, I don't know what are the results are going to be like. I could assume. What I want to make sure is when I yank on it, it doesn't come out, and it doesn't. Let me see how it looks on the mount. What it looks like. Now I can see that I've left some mesh on the sides, which is okay because now we have to trim them.
SiriusXM's new hard rock from I Empire. This is more than fate.
Trim that side. Now I'll trim this side. Now, if you look at the wires, you're going to notice. Let me focus that for you. Look at that. Okay. And I can yank on it, it's not going to come out, which is good. Now this is the version 2 drip OD base that's on here, as you can tell. Now if you have version 1, you can still accomplish this. the way how I wrap my negative connector that I've shown in Vape TV, how to avoid leaks and stuff, and to give a good connection, negative connection, that's exactly what I'm going to do here. So, being that I loosened up this right here, okay, this part, as you can see, it's, you can see a little bit of a gap between the plastic and there on the center pin. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the plastic down. There we go. So now the plastic, as you can see, is here, right on the bottom, okay, which exposes that little metal that you see there in the center. So on the metal channel side, that's what we're going to screw in first. We're going to wrap first. We're going to wrap the wire 1 360-degree angle. That's it, just 1 360, okay, touching that center, okay, and it's inside where the plastic is. Now here, you want to tighten it. Okay, so as I'm screwing it up, what I'm doing is I'm pulling down as it's, so it can screw the nut. See, now it's, now what I get is I can use this, and what I do is I loosen the 510 nut, this one right here, and then with my pliers I tighten the rotary wheel that's there, and I just do a little bit of a turn, that's it, just to keep it snugged and tight. So that will give you a better connection. Plus this wire, you don't have to bend it up at all, it's snug, it's already snugged in there. Now what you can do is with this excess of wire that's there, you can just slice it. Okay, then this one, you can do your normal wrap, 1 360, there we go. Then this wire you can cut. Just like that. This O-ring. Let's add some bass. Just a little bit. That way, as you're screwing it down, it doesn't turn the nut anymore and break your positive line. Okay? So now you can put this ring on. Okay. Now you can put it on the base. You want to keep screwing it until at least you get the 510 a little bit out. There we go. Now you can tighten this ring. There we go. Okay, so I already have it mounted. Let me focus it up. There it is. Okay, so it is pure mesh 400 stainless steel using non-resistance wires. That's it, okay? So I'm gonna prime it up. Okay, I'm gonna use toasted almond from Juicy Vapor. As I said on Vape TV the other night, I am so stoked about this juice. So I put it on. All right, it's soaked. I'm gonna put the tip on. Okay, so now let's get ready. All right, so to recap, we have mesh with non-resistance wires, only mesh and non-resistance wires, no silica wick of any kind. The mesh has not been oxidized, and I'm gonna be the guinea pig. So let's get a fresh, here we go, 18650 MNKEs, okay? And you know what? I know Emil mentioned on the forum, you know, you gotta use a variable voltage device, but you know what? I am so confident. I'm extremely confident, because he mentioned to go up to 6 volts. Well, let me tell you something. I am so confident. I'm gonna trust in GGTS, baby. No kick of any kind. 18650. Okay. Ooh, look. I'm trusting in it. Forget about it. Here we go. Now put the drip mode on. Trusting in it. All right. Like I said, I trust in his devices, man. Here I go. Let's give it a whirl. Wow. I know you mentioned to put in like up to 6 volts and stuff, but I'm scratching my head because to use this just mesh with non-resistance wires as its own conductive and wick at the same time. Oh, marone de mi. Wow, I'm gonna have to dip some more juice in it. It's different, that's for sure. It gives me like a sweeter taste in a way. It's weird. I have toasted almonds, I have it on here. Matter of fact, hold on. You know, I'm not gonna tell you the pros and differences between, you know, the two devices here. I'm just tasting it wise. Hold on. Wash out my palate with some water. Wow. I get a little bit different flavor. It's helped to organize last week. It was
such a great success, and I'm just so grateful that they took the time to come all the way from Vancouver down to New York City to be a part of the event. I wish them so much success in 2013, and I'll keep you informed about
I love this juice.
On Facebook.
So I know what it tastes like
on their page, on our channel page, as well as my own.
But it's giving me a different taste on here that I'm enjoying. I'm really
My name's Kayla. Thanks so much for being a part of the family as we continue to enjoy a long weekend here on Octane with Miranda.
Wow. To me, I'm enjoying the juice more on this right now than the taste I'm getting on here. And still, the taste I get here is good. I'm not knocking it. I know there's plenty of people that enjoy it. But I'm getting a little bit notes that it's a little sweeter. I'm the one that would say I don't think there's much of a difference in taste in resistance wires, but apparently there is. My palate is giving me something different here that I'm enjoying a lot more. It's really tremendous. Wow. And this is at 4.2 volts. Let me see if I can get it to work on my ex-wife. Let's see. Being that he recommended going up a little higher. Okay. I mean, I can double stack the batteries, but then it'll be like past 6 volts, you know? It'll be like 8.4 or 7.5, about the 7-point range. But let me raise it up. Let me put some more juice. And the beauty of this, I could just keep dumping juice in there. Okay. Let's bring it up some more. I'm surprised it actually worked on here. My ex-wife said hello. Let's see if she opens up her legs a little more. Put it at 4.6. The infamous E1, baby. She didn't put out. Alright, well, she put out a 4.... Let me reduce a little more. Go to 4.4. She's not opening up her legs now. Oh well. Let me leave it back at 4.2. See if that still works. Two does it. Wow. Put it back in my GGTS. Wow. The flavor. Definitely, I'm enjoying it a lot more on here. The taste is a little, it's like, it got better. Let's put it that way. I noticed the notes are brighter on the almonds than what I get on here. Something, man, it's Imeo. Nice thought. That's a really, really, really good thought. Would this be safe for someone to try? I wouldn't advise it because, I mean, as you saw, as I did the wrap on the non-resistance wire, you gotta have a little bit of experience in how to do that. I mean, you can practice and try it, but it's all in the way how you wrap that coil on there. Imeo, you're brilliant. You're ingenious. It's unbelievable. I mean, I don't know why I didn't think of it like that. I know we experimented in the past using the mesh as the resistance wire around the wick, which also gave it a different taste, I remember. And then there was an issue with the ohms fluctuating like crazy, but doing it like this, wow. I just hope Clouds of Vapor will stock on mesh, hint hint. It's delicious. Imeo, thank you so much for that idea. Thank you for giving me a blessing to try to put this on a video. I mean, you guys just saw me doing it for the very first time. And I'm digging it. That's for sure. And I can't believe it actually worked on my ex-wife. Wow. Okay. So with that, I'll let you guys go. Enjoy the rest of the day. Live hard and vape hard, baby.